The introduction of the brand new Socket AM5, manufactured to support the next-gen 7000 series processors, was for AMD a historical moment. Many believe that this fact alone marked the end of life of the previous M4 platform upon which AMD successfully built the Ryzen dynasty. Against the above assumption, this video will prove to you that this is not the end of Socket M4, but rather the beginning of its second life cycle. Furthermore, we will offer a valuable and sustainable proposition for you on how to build a gaming/productivity PC with used parts and avoid the risk of a bad investment. To do so, we have to look back in February of 2017 at the launch of Ryzen microarchitecture, codenamed Zen, and its compatible Socket M4, ready to accommodate AMD's new processors. Following the somewhat boring prefix codename lineage of its predecessors, AM4 was by far one of the most interesting platforms ever created. Its main function was to support a series of evolutionary processor units. Starting with the affordable and high core count 1000 series processors, followed by the even better priced, refreshed and bug-free Zen Plus architecture, transitioning to the much improved Zen 2 CPUs, followed by one more and bit confusing refreshment with the 4000 series, and completed this 5-year journey with the top-of-the-line 5000 series. Definitely a family line of processors that not only saved AMD from imminent bankruptcy, but brought AMD back to the forefront of the semiconductor industry. Not a shabby achievement at all, considering also the emerging challenges that came with the endeavor to fuse all those technological advances into an aging socket that at the time, not even AMD itself thought that AM4 could successfully make it beyond 2020. Although this has been an interesting story, it doesn't explain how the end of the life cycle of this amazing socket is only the beginning of a new one. The first hint of explanation came from AMD's CEO and president, Lisa Su, during the keynote presentation of Computex 2022.
Now, while AM4 is a great platform that will continue for many years to come, building the best PCs is always about pushing the envelope.
This statement is a strong affirmation that the existing AM4 socket will be around for a while. Although it does not provide details on the precise meaning, we can only presume that it will be one or two things. The first is that the AMD team will continue to support the AM4 platform with drivers and BIOS updates. The other is that AMD will manufacture a few more AM4 CPUs. A first taste of that was the presentation of Ryzen 7 5800X3D, the first AMD CPU that integrated 64MB of 3D VCache along with the 32MB standard cache, claiming superior gaming performance. Another indication that AMD is committed to Socket AM4 is the AGSA microcode updates that offers not only higher performance stability but also allows the old B350 and X370 chipset motherboards to support the latest and greatest Zen 3 based processors. Thus, now every owner of 300 and 400 series AMD motherboard has the opportunity to upgrade to a 5000 series AMD CPU. And everyone with low budget can build a PC upon the AM4 motherboard with a cheap first or second gen Ryzen CPU, and at some point upgrade to a more powerful 5th gen Ryzen processor. You will ask, of course, why you mention only AMD, and why not build a PC with used Intel components? And the answer is simple. You can choose any Haswell or older Intel micro architecture with the corresponding motherboard and RAM, but the technology is now so old that not only it doesn't offer any upgradability options, but it also hinders the performance of modern hardware and software. With the aged PCI Express and USB interfaces, the absence of M.2 slots, the unsupported drivers, and the Windows 11 incompatibility. Unofficially, there is a way to force Windows 11 to support old architectures, but that's not the point. The same problems, but in a lesser degree, goes for every Intel Skylake and Kaby Lake, or even for the first-gen AMD Ryzen CPUs. I place them in the same group because they all belong more or less on the same era. Back then, the Intel Core i5-7600K and i7-7700K were superior on gaming performance, respectively, to the AMD R5-1600 and R7-1700 CPUs. 5 years later, and the majority of modern games utilize more than 4 cores, making a better choice the higher core count of Ryzen CPUs, while equalizing the game performance difference between Kaby Lake and Bristol Ridge architectures. You can go for some more recent Intel architecture, which Windows 11 officially supports, along with every AMD CPU made after the first gen architecture. Unfortunately, most of Intel's 8th generation and beyond CPUs are overpriced. But the most concerning thing of all is that we are basically talking about discontinued platforms. With exception of the 12th and 13th gen, the rest of Intel's core CPUs are offering zero upgradability. And even the latest and greatest Raptor Lake in 1 year will be in the same spot due to Intel's strategy of applying the microprocessor's TikTok model to the supporting sockets as well, eliminating their upgradability after only 2 generations of CPUs. This is why AMD's plan to support and extend the lifespan of the AM4 platform for so long has been a massive success for Team Red, and it's the main reason why I recommend you build a Ryzen system. As for the matter of price, I wouldn't spend for a used AMD AM4 barebone system more than 60% of the money I would spend to buy new, the cheapest AMD Ryzen or Intel Alder Lake barebone system. With minimum barebone system, I mean a 4 cores 8 thread CPU, a compatible motherboard, and at least 2 sticks of total 16GB DDR4 RAM. So, if the new system costs $230, then a used AMD barebone system with almost the same performance shouldn't exceed the $160. Bear in mind that buying computer components separately is pricier than buying a fully assembled second-hand PC. Now, let's move from the theory to the second and more practical part of this video. This is MSI B450M mortar, an AMD B450 chipset implemented on M4 Micro ATX motherboard that I bought used 2 years ago at considerably low price, mainly because that the previous owner had lost the input-output shield. Not a biggie for me, since I could replace it with one of these plastic modifiable backplates. Today you can find a bunch of used B350 and B450 or even X370 or X470 chipset AMD motherboards at a very good price. All of them capable to accommodate any Ryzen M4 CPU with a simple BIOS update. Do not spend more than $50 to $60 on those, otherwise you break the purpose of your budget-friendly PC build, which is to be budget-friendly. Next is the matter of the central processor unit. In our example, I'm using a Ryzen 7 1700, but of course there is a big variety of choices to pick from. CPUs that range from 4 cores 8 threads up to 8 cores 16 threads. If you want to just game, then choose the lowest core range. If you want to simultaneously run many programs while you play games, or you want to use your computer also for productivity tasks, then go for a higher core count. A good middle-range solution is the Ryzen 5 1600, the AF version, or a Ryzen 5 2600. Keep the purchase cost at $60 to $70 and do not go more than that. Otherwise, spend a bit more and use the affiliate links in the description to buy brand new the 6 cores 4000 or even 5000 AMD CPUs at a discount price. Keep in mind that there are some Ryzen APU processors that integrate a low-performance graphics processor unit inside them. If you don't care much about gaming, it's a clever way to reduce further the cost of your PC build. To complete your barebone system, you have to choose a pair of DDR4 memory sticks. 3200 mega transfers per second is the safest choice in terms of compatibility. 16GB capacity is the sweet spot for any modern gaming rig. Finding used DDR4 RAM at good bargain is very rare, unless you buy bulk. And even if you find a good price, it is usually $5 to $10 less per module than to buy new. I don't see the reason to throw away the convenience of return, refund and guarantee policy of a new product for a few bucks difference. But then again, it is your budget, your decision. The rest of the components are interchangeable. Regardless of your system, choose a SSD storage device of at least 512GB, preferably in M.2 form if your motherboard supports it. The PC case will be able to accommodate the form of your motherboard. Go for an ATX case to ensure the best possible compatibility with the rest of your PC components. Possible extra fans that comes with the PC case is a bonus. Your CPU cooler should be anything better than AMD's stock solution. There are a plethora of new CPU coolers at great prices. Of course, you can use the stock cooler if you go super low budget and replace it when you upgrade to a 5th gen Ryzen processor. All the above need power to work, thus a non-brand power supply unit is a necessary addition to the list. Anything between 500 to 700 watt is perfect depending on your system total consumption, and that means you need to know which graphics card, if any, will complete your computer build. Speaking of which, click at the appearing screen tabs where I have some budget-friendly but pretty decent performing GPU recommendations for you. There is also the recommendation to leave your like if you like, subscribe to our channel if you haven't done so already, and press the notification bell if you don't want to miss our upcoming videos. Regardless, thanks for watching, and see you on the next one.